Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Israel Brief brought to you by Lay of the Land. It's a little bit dark, but I'm a little bit time traveled because I've just arrived in gorgeous Melbourne, Australia, on my WITSO tour of the country for the WITSO Australia Triennial Conference. But let's get into today's top story. And Israel is preparing for a very, very busy week of entertainment as the Eurovision Song Contest kicks off in Tel Aviv today. Israel has welcomed contestants, delegations, tourists, music enthusiasts from at least 41 European countries and other countries around the world who have descended on Tel Aviv for what is sure to be the party of the century. We are waiting for Madonna to arrive tomorrow, and there's a lot of anticipation about that. And you know, may the best country win. And just to recap, Israel is hosting Eurovision after our contestant Netta Barzilai won last year's competition. So all bets are open. Which country is going to win? And we're also hoping that countries like Iceland are not going to use the stage for their controversial propagandizing. They plan to use their set at Eurovision to protest what they say is Israel's apartheid policies towards the Palestinians. But Israel is neither an apartheid country, and neither is Eurovision the stage to make such kind of political statements. Now, more further afield, and two stories coming out of the United States. The first is that Hanan Ashrawi, many of you will be familiar with her as the spokesperson for the Palestinians through a lot of issues over the last couple of years, has been denied her visa of entry into the United States. She is claiming that the U.S. is barring her entry because she is critical of Israel, but she is a 70-year-old grandmother and not a threat to society. But there is obviously reasons why Hanan Ashrawi is being banned entry and staying in the United States. And yet another controversial statement by rookie Democratic Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib, who President Trump has called a tremendous hater of Jews and Israel. And this is for her Holocaust revisionist comments that it was her ancestors, her family, that gave refuge, so to speak, to Jews coming into the country from Europe after the Holocaust. This is blatant Holocaust revisionism. Palestinians weren't chased out of the country by Jews coming in from Europe. In fact, when the State of Israel was declared and Ben-Gurion invited the Arab residents of the time to join the Jewish community to work towards building a country, they refused, having chosen to listen to their leaders who advised them to flee until they had driven the Jews into the sea and then return so that they could take their homes, or whatever was left after the spoils of war. So not only is this profoundly offensive and Holocaust revisionism, it is also historically incorrect, and it remains to be seen what Tlaib's trajectory will be moving forward. Don't forget that you can read more about Israel's history and other interesting facts online at www.layoftheland.online. Check out Dave Kaplan's article on Yom HaAtzmaut, and take a little bit of time travel back with him as he looks at some of the events taking place around Israel's Declaration of Independence. Also, we are growing on Facebook, guys, and if you are not there with us, why not? Let's fix that immediately, and you can like us and join us on Facebook at Lotl Site. Also, click on the subscribe link below to get your daily edition of the Israel Brief straight to a device near you. Kid you not. And we'll chat again a little later with more news headlines of the day. I'm Raleen Marks for the Israel Brief.